Now, speaking of content, syempre, a lot of people know you now because of your YouTube videos, your content. So is YouTubing, being a YouTuber, something that you're really pursuing now? Ito na ba talaga yung path mo? What got you started into YouTube?
Actually, nagsimula to nung nag-decide ako, 1 week na nagda-diet na ako. Sabi ko kasi, parang it's one way for me to be more inspired na magpapayad. Kasi pag may vlog ka, syempre pag nasimula mo na siya, mas magiging obligado ka in a way na i-update yung mga tao sa current changes sa katawan mo. So, nag-decide talaga ako, sabi ko, sige, mag-YouTube ako and I want to inspire a lot of people. Kasi ako, alam niyo naman to, for more than years, I've struggled with my, you know, with my body, with my weight. And naging problema natin yan for so many times. And sabi ko, I mean, blessing in disguise, ECQ that time also. So sabi ko, mag-vlog na lang ako para ma-obligado rin ako na gawin talaga to every day. Mm-hmm. So with that, yun, nag-work naman siya. So thank you, Lord.
So what's amazing is you started a resolution for yourself and then you decided to share it to people, but it brought you to a place where you're actually flourishing right now. And maybe some people think na we're body shaming. Kasi usin yung body shaming.
No.
Na parang kapag mataba ka, may problema ba tayo? Dapat be appreciated.
Yeah.
All body types. And I agree with that. But there's also an element with health na kasama sa parte ng taking care of yourself is actually being healthy.
Yeah.
Now, losing weight is not always equivalent to being healthy.
Yes.
Yung having abs and looking good doesn't always equate to being healthy. Especially kung hindi quality food yung kinakain mo or you're crash dieting, that's also not healthy. In the same way na obesity doesn't mean healthy as well. So, yeah. One way of taking care of yourself is to actually lose that weight safely by strict diet and working out.
Yeah.
And that's what Daniel did. And what I admire about you, bro, is you were not ashamed to share to people the process.
Yeah.
Kasi
yeah.
Ang hirap nun, i-reveal mo sa mga tao na I'm struggling with my weight.
Yes.
Ang hirap magpigil kumain. But since you opened up your life to people, that actually brought you to a place now that yun nga, obviously you're flourishing and you know, a lot of great things, a lot of blessings.
Actually, isang eye-opener sa akin talaga bakit ako nagpapayat is nagkaroon ng kidney stone. Nadala ko sa ospital. So, parang nag-suffer ako for more than 3 weeks. Talagang nahihirapan talaga ako. And then also, nahihirapan ako huminga. Hindi ako makatulog sa gabi. Nung time na ginagawa ko yun, nag-stream ako. Talagang eating habits ko. Wala pa ako sa MAPS noon that time. So, it was really, really bad. So, sabi ko, let's do it one by one. So, ngayon yung content, dun ko pinasok yung diet ko, yung relationship ko talaga with the Lord. I want to be more vocal also na kaya talaga, nothing is impossible if you do it and you put God first. So ako, nilagay ko ng unang-una si Lord sa buhay ko. Sabi ko, Lord, lalo na nagka-kidney stone talaga ako. Sabi ko, ayaw ko na ng ganito. I don't want to suffer anymore. I want to be healthy. I want to be healthy for you. I want to live longer. Gusto ko mas ma-share pa yung story na binuo mo sa akin to more people. Kasi ngayon, parang natutuwa nga ako. Well, I am blessed also and honored ako na meron talaga mga tao, meron ng audience na naghihintay ng story ako. And I want to use that properly by inspiring them and giving them motivation.